Hey, I got a new helper here. This is Marvin Butler, come all the way from Arkansas to hand me these signs today. Here's a nice young fellow from Wisconsin, I think. Minnesota? We'll find out. He's a Minnesotan. David Cavalari, would you come on up here? No running. No running in the halls. Hi, David. Welcome back to the stage. Now, I got a chance to send part of my summer. He was one of our two piano players on the Spirit of Peoria Riverboat that went all the way to Starve Rock, Illinois last summer, and he was one of our volunteers for that trip, and he and his wife made the journey. Even persuaded him to get a CD done in time for the trip, and he did. He made them at home, ironed them out there on the ironing board himself. And Dave, tell the folks a little bit about yourself.
Well, let's see. I just finished my second bachelor's degree. I now have a BA and BS, so I'm a software engineer now, but I also do this in my spare time.
BS part I can understand.
Me too, yeah. Let's see. So I do this in my spare time. I've been doing it. I've been trying to do it since I was a kid. Never had a piano as a kid, but I did have a harmonica, so I had lots of songbooks with old songs in them. So I guess I just got the bug from that, maybe.
And your interest in music goes to straight ragtime, classics, standard tunes?
Whatever speaks to me. I like to try to play things in my own way a little bit when I can. But I really like just, I've been very interested in more obscure music that you don't hear all the time, just because it's, oh, here's this cool thing that everyone forgot about. And it's like finding buried treasure or something.
What are you gonna play first for us?
Well, this is my first one, so I thought I'd start with a nice, easy warm-up piece. This piece by Willie the Lion Smith, it's called Fingerbuster.
Fingerbuster sounds like an easy tune, all right. Well, David, tell us a little bit about yourself outside of the college and the music end. What do? You go fishing or do you do anything?
You know, I've forgotten at this point. I've been in school for so long. No, I do this. We've gotten into the farmer's markets lately in Minneapolis. We like just walking over there. Let's see, like reading.
Okay, we don't allow reading here, so that's gonna be out. What are you gonna play second for us?
Well, my fingers are feeling pretty busted after playing Fingerbuster, so I'm gonna give my fingers a break, and I'm gonna play the Fingerbreaker. It's a piece by Jelly Roll Morton, first recorded in December 1938 on the flip side of a record with Creepy Feeling. People often get them confused, but this one's by a different guy.
The name of the tune again?
Name of the tune is The Fingerbreaker by Jelly Roll Morton.
Give you 15 minutes to walk around. We're going to take a break after our fifth contestant and do five more this morning. Please take a look at the tables. Please visit our dealer's room, and please be back in about 15 minutes.